everyone, and welcome to this edition of Race-Based Driver Updates. I'm Brittany Lung. Let's get started with our race-based drivers. Sheldon Creed was at Bristol Motor Speedway for the Gander Outdoor Truck Series, where he was fast during practice but had some electrical issues in his GMS Racing Chevrolet in qualifying, resulting in a 24th starting position for the 200-lap feature. Sheldon knew he had to be patient if he wanted to have a shot at a win. He charged hard all night, moving through the field, running as high as second, and eventually finishing sixth, his third consecutive top 10 finish. Up next for Sheldon, the trucks take to the road course at Canadian Tire Motorsports Park on August 25th. Sam Mayer was at Bristol Motor Speedway, where he would pull double duty in both the NASCAR K&N Series East race and make his debut in the NASCAR Gander Outdoor Truck Series. Let's start with the K&N race, where Sam qualified second, but was involved in an incident on lap one that resulted in NASCAR sending him to the rear of the field for the restart. But he quickly made his way back through the field. By lap 50 scheduled break, he was already inside the top five. For the next 80 laps, Sam followed the leader, just waiting for the right time to make his move, and with 13 to go, used the bump and run to take the lead and never looked back, cruising to the victory by almost 2 seconds to sweep both NASCAR K&N Pro Series Bristol events this year. Sam remains in the point lead heading into this weekend's race at Gateway Motorsports Park in St. Louis. Let's change gears and take a look at the second part of Sam's day, the NASCAR Gander Outdoor Truck Series race. The GMS team unloaded and they were fast in early practice, posting in the top five all day, but was only able to pull off an 18th starting position in qualifying. Sam was very patient in the early going, but was moving through the field and by the end of stage two was sitting in 10th place before pitting for fuel, four tires, and adjustments. He started the final stage in 12th, but was up to 9th by lap 166. A late red flag stopped the race and he restarted 10th with 11 laps to go. But with only 8 laps to go, Ben Rhodes hit Sam, sending him into the wall, ending his night, and was credited with a 21st place finish. Jesse Love had a busy weekend with 4 races in 4 days, scheduled in the Power I National Midget League. He started at Fairbury American Legion Speedway, where he finished 5th in his heat race, then started 15th in the feature, and finished 17th in the A-Main. It was then on to Lincoln Fairgrounds, where the team finished 4th in the heat race and brought home a 15th place finish in the feature. On night 3, the teams were headed to Macon Speedway, but Mother Nature had other plans and the night was rained out. Now on to night 4 at Jacksonville Speedway, where the event had a little bit of a twist to it. Jesse started the evening by winning his heat race, then finished 4th in the qualifying race, earning him a 9th place starting spot for the feature. The KKM team and drivers struggled in the main event and was only able to bring home a 14th place finish. Not exactly what they were looking for. Up next for Jesse, back to Jacksonville on August 23rd. Joe Valento was at Madison International Speedway in Oregon, Wisconsin, and as usual, the Kelly Byers Racing Performance team had their Nitro Lubricant Arnott Mill Chevrolet fast in qualifying in 5th place. Joe started his heat race in 4th, but quickly found his way to the front and remained there, taking the checkered flag. Now on to the feature race, where he started 6th and was passing for 3rd when he got spun by another truck that resulted in a damaged left rear tire that required a pit stop for repairs. Joe restarted at the tail end of the 24 truck field, but raced his way back to a 6th place finish, the 5th consecutive top 10 finish for the young rookie driver. Up next for Joe, Dells Raceway Park on August 31st. Let's move on to our race face next drivers. William Cox was pulling double duty this weekend, running the legend car at Anderson Motor Speedway, where he qualified 2nd and finished 3rd overall, and 2nd in Young Lions, even after slight contact with the wall on lap 1. Now on to Virginia International Speedway, where Will was in his spec Miata with Panic Motorsports for 2 days of racing. On Saturday, after a few rain delays, the final got started, but Will got off track in one of the turns, but still managed an 11th place finish. On Sunday, he started the race in 4th and finished in 4th. After the race, Will said, "It was a great weekend of racing. I had a fast car and I learned a lot." Up next for Will, Legend Racing at Anderson on Friday, and back to Atlanta Motor Speedway for the Fall Series on Saturday. Bryce Bezanson was at the Evergreen Speedway for the NASCAR Whelen All-American Series Enos Oil 100. The track was also playing host to the NASCAR K&N Pro Series West Cars, so they were using the larger, faster 5/8 mile track. Bryce qualified 14th in his Friends of Jaclyn Foundation No. 7 Ford. Early in the race, a car on the inside lost control, putting him into the wall. The Jefferson Pitts Racing team was able to repair the damage and keep him on the lead lap. He eventually brought home a top 10 finish in 9th place. Up next for Bryce, he will be back at Evergreen Speedway on August 31st. Race face drivers who didn't compete last week but will see action this week include Brian Henderson, who will be at Virginia International Raceway in the IMSA Michelin Pilot Series, Connor Mosack, who will be at the Hickory Motor Speedway in the NASCAR Whelen All-American Series, Adam Lemke, who will be at Orange County Speedway with the Cars Tour, Minnie Tyrell will also be back with the Cars Tour at Orange County Speedway, Joey East will be at the Madeira Speedway in both the Junior Late Model and the Pro Late Model, Jake Bowman will also return to the Junior Late Model at Madeira, Cassidy Hines returns to the Pro Truck at Colorado National Speedway. Both Kobe and Justice Sokol will be in their non-winged micro sprints at El Paso County Raceway. Grant Thompson will return to the Southern Pro-Am Truck Series at Highland Rim Speedway in Nashville, Tennessee. It's now time to get an update on the Junior Late Model Challenge Camp that was held at Madeira Speedway over the weekend. So let's check in with Rod Wortham for that update.
Thanks, Brittany. The camp was amazing. It was absolutely one of the best things that I've ever been a part of. We had 15 drivers there from all over the country, even a young lady and her mom from England. The kids all came there to compete against each other, but left the camp as friends and made relationships that will last forever. I also can't say enough about the parents. All of them were thankful just to have had the opportunity to participate. We held multiple seminars throughout the day on topics such as sponsorship, marketing, media. I want to thank Kenny Shepherd and Stephen Blakesley for everything they did to make the seminar so educational. On the race car side, the Nate Clower team, led by Mike Nake, was off the chart. Every one of Mike's crew, Tony, Rob, Gary, Mike, Anthony, and Andy, and Trace, you guys are awesome. And the one that kept all of us on point was Sharon Nate. A special thanks to Richie and Tricia East, and a big thank you to Tom Clower and the West Coast Stock Car Hall of Fame. And finally, to all the young drivers. You are all winners in my book. I wish you all the success throughout the rest of the year, and I will see one of you back at Madeira on October the 5th. The bottom line is, it was a very successful camp, and I can't wait till next year to do it all over again. But not in August, because it was over 103 degrees every day. Back to you, Brittany.
Thanks, Rod. It sounds like the kids and parents had a truly remarkable 2 days. That's it for this week's Race Face Driver Updates. And remember, if you've missed any of our shows, you can get caught up on raceface.tv on demand. Don't miss Race Face Spotlight on Thursdays at 10 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, this week featuring Pro Truck Series driver Cassidy Hines. As always, we encourage you to support local racing in your communities. Don't forget to follow us on social media. We'll be back with you next week for more from your favorite Race Face drivers. Get out there, have a great race week. I'm Brittany Lung. Thanks for watching.